다들이제그유말은진순주수순배당위시기단레짐님마탐부디이마레다디토리아치유남베접지르무즈남바니주우론제단에켈로게시니아남당대신도세계미마랭게바상원로리아토마라가수섬주샤이
Today is the first day of the program of the actual 33rd Kagyu Mama. And so I'd like to begin by welcoming the two Lords of Refuge, Jamgon and Jalsab Rinpoche, as well as all of the Kenpo's masters, all of the members of the ordained Sangha and lay people.
다 드린디 말람 구시 갑리야 슈야 디 가담베 다 가담 구제 숨세 용서 차대와 디난 데네 가담베 기회 신인 첨부 오다 계시 보도베 로종 칠럽지 뉴기 토네 마지 주시샤이스
And so today, as the teaching during the actual munam, I would like to teach from the long soliloquy by the one of the three great forefathers of the Kadampa lineage, the great Kadampa master Potowa.
That. 최 진인 제외 걸려야 네 가르쳐야 되네 지게 지게 최 제바 보이면이야 샌디에 군론다 만접에 관해 최시에 고요래 최 년바 보이면이야 아니 지 수든 팀에 관해 최년 고요
When we are teaching and listening to the Dharma, the teacher must teach the Dharma with a motivation that is not connected with the aims of this life. And likewise, the listeners must also listen properly. And so the motivation for listening should be listening with a motivation that is not mixed with the three faults of the different types of vessels.
다 되라야 당 뇌기 균순디 당부디 카부부더비 균스와래 다디 가르스와래서나 베나 쓸당 우유기 뇌라 소비하기 뇌 상해 컨디션이 비이네야 디 카부부니 샤샤비 이미나 추 컨디 지지지 로베 이나야 안 나도 민조와 난신기 지 르부디 지 최슈제 텔이야 대여베 이미나야 소소기 최디 암조 야보 많이 해미체 네 지 나와 텔이야 안 지 가서 르바 마데베 텔이 세비나 안 최도고야만
And so of the three faults of a vessel, the first is being like a vessel that is upside down, or a bowl that is upside down. So no matter what type of bowl you have, whether it be gold or silver or any other type of bowl, if it is upside down, no matter how much water you pour into it, none of it will remain in the dish or the bowl. Likewise, we might be sitting physically in the hall among the ranks of those listening to the Dharma. But if we do not listen, if we do not direct our attention to what is coming in through our ears, then we will not receive the Dharma.
And 다가 나신기 암쇼기 녀바 이네야 야지 가르르지 직버 딤제 엔 시그드윈 이라 마신비 이미나 직제 던추 노래 직제 던추 소나 데네 냠소 렘베 즉 냠소 렌다 마셰 바로 샤도요 아르드니 디 균젤 데네 나웨 엄부 녀바 나웨 엄부 녀바 좀도 마셰비 이기시바 때네 시드윈 만제바 야보제제 아다 가주에 년과디 계속 자
The second fault is being like a leaky bowl. And so even if a bowl is right side up, if it has a crack or a hole in the bottom, then when you pour water into it, that water will not stay. It'll just spill out the bottom or flow out the bottom. Similarly, when we're listening to the Dharma, if we listen to it, but we do not pay attention to the words and we do not catch and hold on to the words, then we will forget the words and the meaning, and then we will not know how we should practice. And so not only do we need to listen to the words, we also need to focus our mental consciousness on them and listen so that we do not forget the words and the meaning.
다드네 숨바디 뇌 두젠더 위견 숨바디 The
third type is of a vessel with poison in it, and there are two types of this.
다 두젠 세두사 가르소르사나 뇌 지금 나로래 두지 예베체 두 예베 인두사 디 나로래 예 칼라야 뭐 컨드지 비 세베 미네야 디 두단 제베 칼라차디 예베 인두사 아주 살로 말했어. 다가난 신기 아주 그지 최년배 갑리야 간다지 수수기 심규디 지 군론 장마 많이 비치 군론 양다바 많이 봐 군론 년바단 제제 아니 최년 많이 비나 아니 독단 제베 세신 차도르스
So if there is poison in the bottom of a bowl, then you may put whatever food you put in it will not be suitable to eat. Likewise, when we are listening to the Dharma, if we do not have a pure motivation in our mind, if we have an unclear, or if our if we have a motivation that is mixed with bad motivations, then it is like poisoned food and something that we should not take.
텔라야 that 두 민자 리 민자 니르 조디와레 다데 찌데 가나 심제 찌리야 간다라 유에데베 저 전신 행계 유에데베 세라는 민도 다 간다지 그 심진 지접리야 유에데베게 지 차담모 송게 도 디 릭지
Now there are two different types of the poison. The first of these are the greed, hatred, and desire that all sentient beings have, that are naturally present in all sentient beings. So this is one of the types of poison. And so what is this poison like? Well, it's like when we are listening to the Dharma, if we have great attachment and great desire for food or for clothing, popularity or becoming rich and prosperous, if we have that sort of attachment, great attachment and desire when we listen, and we think to ourselves, oh, I'm listening to the Dharma so that my business will go well, or so that I'll become popular, become famous, then this is associated with the poison of desire and greed.
다나 신기야 지금 최 제베걸이야 나야 지금 시단단 제베관다지 장가 달라 당심다 된데게 토네지 야 지 군롱에 받은 제네 최연비나 뇽모바 시단단 제베 시단가 토단 제베 다지 가주에 뇌는 차리요
Likewise, when during a Dharma teaching, if our motivation is associated with hatred, for example, if we have malice for our enemies or that sort of a bad motivation, then we are like a vessel that has filled with poison that is related to the affliction of anger or of hatred. Now the affliction of delusion is like when we do not understand the nature of things. We do not realize that the Dharma is teaching us what we need to do and what we should not need to do. It teaches us how we need to think on a more profound and deeper level about benefit and happiness, our temporary benefit and our ultimate happiness. It identifies what we need to do and what we should avoid in order to bring this. But if we do not recognize what we should do and what we should avoid, and instead and do not realize and do not have any thought of what we should do or what we should give up, and listen in this way, then this is mixed with the poison of delusion and misunderstanding. The point of our listening, contemplating, and meditating is to eliminate the three poisons of the afflictions. It's to see how well we are able to eliminate them. So for that reason, from the moment we begin listening, we need to recognize and identify what the three poisons are. And if we identify those and eliminate them, then our listening, contemplating, and meditation will go well. If we do not recognize, then we can listen, contemplate, and meditate until we become quite learned. But we will not be. But it will be difficult for us to liberate ourselves from samsara.
Jidanga Aradu Rabdu Chuada, Chogol Shuadi, Jidin Tame Beijing, Yomu Tusum Shiaga Chedo, Tele Joyaga Chedo, Azu, Chogol Shu, Rabdu Chum, the Chevre.
Now, the second type of poison is the poison of engaging in philosophy, and this is actually a quite scary one. And the reason for this is that the reason why we go forth, the reason why we enter the gate of the Dharma, is in order to protect ourselves from the three worldly poisons.
That's 드린 친지 안다 교랑지 나 말다 다 드린 친지 나랑 거주베 인사 아니지 더규베 인사 말을 드리지 삼다 다 드네 갈리갈리지 출루 다 규베 미지베 라마신달라 다 고 거주베 라마 마레 더규베 라마 마레 제제 아니 고라 초다 리스 지에네베 차자면 미제 차차면 Tene jigi chezo zonsong ta, tene jigi taana shingi ka kizun sangsong ki namdar kandre ji yuebe inaya. Ta di jigi duk chenpo dan drebe ki, ta jigi se sangpo dan jenru chi cha che. Tene jigi ta kashuwe, ta nyaka sabshira yuebe.
For example, if we were to go to some master of the Dokpo Kaiju lineage, we go for refuge and then go forth and take ordination. Then from that point on, we begin to say, I'm Kaiju, I'm in the Dokpo Kaiju lineage. And then we think about the, when we think about the masters of other lineages, we say, oh, they're not Kaiju, they're not in the Dokpo Kaiju. And we start to have more bias, and we have a sectarian clinging. If we don't, then we start not even prostrating to them. And in addition to not even prostrating, we criticize both their dharma and the individuals. Then this is just like adding fuel to a fire. When we enter the gate of the dharma, we enter in order to pacify the three poisons. But by engaging in this philosophy and school, then we increase our attachment and aversions. We increase our sectarian biases. And if we do this, no matter what we do with the Dharma, whether listening, teaching, or debating, or no matter what external form of being learned, venerable, good we have, it is just like food in which great poison has been mixed, and this is a terrible danger.
Nalo tuk yume ko tani, nyoshe di tsangwa yume tani, an kala soko resu. Teka nanshi nga zu jik chwe chewe kao li nare, chwe nyebe kao li nare, kante jik tuesam kuzu kare chewe kao li, thangpo nye li a jik. Oda tinte wiyo ka taka jik gunlong nyenpa ama, tando na jik chakdang monsum dan jendo mido, takje che. Tene, jik, Kashuwe jen mindu na jik tuesam kosum kura chea. Jen du na deba paani tuesam kosum tsangma jiyang bezu chea. Tati gechimura mato begi tuudan jen yueme zawanyi na takje majeba kala shimbu sasha achida sanyi kala kapchorwa. Sanyi tiri indusna di gyuze dene anta di tangbu ni thoma konan nga zu takje chegwaya chire.
And so when you are making food or when you are cooking a meal, then you need to make sure, first of all, that the dishes do not have any poison in them. And then you have to make sure that they are clean. Similarly, when we are teaching or listening to the Dharma, when we are engaging in listening, contemplating, and meditation, at the very beginning, first of all, we need to check and see whether we have a bad motivation. We need to examine whether our motivation is connected with greed, hatred, and delusion or not. If it is not, then we should engage in the listening, contemplating, and meditating. And if it is, we should do what we can to eliminate that and then listen, contemplate, and meditate with a pure motivation. If we do not even examine ourselves and just go ahead and doing this. It's like if we eat food that has poison in it, it's delicious food, but tomorrow morning we will be in great difficulties. And so in that same way, from the very beginning, we must examine our motivations. Now the text for the long soliloquy by Geshe Potowa is actually a fairly rare text. But last year, after we made the plans to teach it during this Munlam, since that time I received three or four different editions or manuscripts of the text. And I think that this is really a very good interdependent connection, a good coincidence. There is a commentary, a meaning commentary on this in the 100 Short Instructions by Mikyo Dorje. There's the extended commentary on the long soliloquy by Potowa. And I have received the Lung transmission for this before, and so I think that in essence, in actuality, I have also received the transmission for this long soliloquy. Now, this long soliloquy, being a text by one of the early Kadampa masters, is written in a colloquial, archaic dialect. And so because it's in this very difficult dialect, I may not be able to explain it very well, but I will do my best.
Tu thoma me ba ne chamba da rasen ma do be lene do sem ma do ba dibe ne diba so so ba ma she be le so so ma she ba teba me be le teba me ba chiwa ma de me len ba yi ta ko ye dung ye gi ji ne ta ba da tham chi ke ba to ba de be rang ge sem to ba che ba le diba jong ba che ba le so so ba la teba ge teba sha ma de chiwa je so ma de ne mi gi chiwa sha ma de ne chu mi ji ge mi be me du nyam za na Jidingi Pusum Soba, Jilaya, Lomijuga, Yon Indi, Tetana, Zeda, Yazella, Chava Tingime, Niendela, Shamba Shamarlon, Suyang, Omison, Yon Do.
The Long Soliloquy by Geshe Potowa. I prostrate to the Gurus of the Three Times. Since beginningless time, we have wandered in the great ocean of suffering, the three realms of samsara. This is because we have not realized our own mind. We have not realized our own mind because of the obscurations. The obscurations come from not knowing that we should gather the accumulations. Not knowing to gather the accumulations is from lacking faith. We lack faith because of not recalling death. Now that because we fear the suffering of samsara, we want to achieve liberation and omniscience, we must realize the mind. To realize the mind, we must purify the obscurations. To purify the obscurations, we must gather the accumulations. To gather the accumulations, we must have faith. But true faith will not arise if we do not recall death. When you truly remember death and think that nothing other than Dharma will help, you will pay no heed to any of the bounties of the world. At that point, you will have no greed, even in the depths of your heart, for material things or necessities. Having genuinely lost all attachment to friends and associates, you will curry favor with no one.
Tajidangi Potowa gave Sinism Potowa Sadi, Senlea, Muller, Jinjin Seshu, Tea, 안주 내린심 뭐 주주고 나로네 안 파바 연락주고 넘주 인스트레 순도아래 대신도 다 까마보 뒤숨 캠베기 다지 꾸기 겨와 고마이마 근데 순도아래 제자디 겨와 고마이마 퍼지 용 제자 대다디 기루기 달라마 기루 게라심보레 롱드 라마르 부치 롱드 라마르 부치기 공부고 나로래야 까마베 군진 진주 지능 주사네 군진 탐보 보도와 군진이바 뒤숨 캠바 소셔 공기야 꾸께와 가르쳐지 지 제사 공기 지단디 지단 전에 당가 좀 넘유 지단디다 뒤서 저거 말다 인비네 다 공기 군진 탐보 보도와 저기 용자로 치도 심바다 제사 뒤숨 캠바도 딱 보도위 지 구제와 이모들 숨고 와래 간다랴 다 뒤치글럽스 치글럽스 해야 돼 아주 하고로 봐 수수 지고 계셔야 되더 봐 수수 지고 지 계셔야 돼 다 치글럽스 해야 돼 된다 하시지 와라 초 진이 시에비네 겁 들리야 아니 년계 민도스 다 당화 시에 년계 민도스 다 수수 지고 지 시에 돼 치글럽으로 잡되나 마도 아니 다 당화 년계 민도스 제가 수수 다지 안드레체나야 뭐 고주데 드레 고도 다 얘는 드레 칭게면도 삼 지수수수 다지 다 삼바교스네 안드란도 야나지 가수라 다지 수수수수 지시에 대한 없이 처진이 드레지 대지 토교에 지 전단 없이 야 전단 지네 삼다면은 지 직접 접사 탕원에 수수수수 지고 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 가수라 다지 심슈우르지 파르다 오늘 진짜 최고도 편대 최고도 삼바르지 다지 수수 탐삼지 최시로 꾀지 레베 나롤 지 삼다 최시 꾀다 땅 오늘 지내지 진짜 최고도 단 다다 보는 진짜 좋음인도 제자 마음 받는 진짜 최고도 삼바르지 진짜 수수 심슈 봐야 하는지 단 너는 칠럽세야디 땅 아주 최상으로 지 카파고 지 밑장장 세디어로 다 딘드르민도 소소소소리야 다 치글럽스네라 소소소소리야 다 계시하고 소소소소리베 트 트두르치엔베 계시시에 랍제자고도 마도 다지 치로로 파카 고르지 미신다라 베티 카나나 어다지 젠 리버티브디 계시시에 데비 미네야데 펜도면도 녜 최신경 코란리야 냠네요마 제사 디 엔다 가르에 가서 디 루버군이 계신 당신의 지 최 최도의 대네 라마 최신게 되서라 냠레메 사마야라라 냠레요 말아서 냠레메 타쳐 자르스 드린 주사네 디소르 차지 다티 된다로 다시 니서 치글스
The great spiritual master Potoa was, his actual name was Rinchen, and he is said to have been a reincarnation or emanation of one of the 16 arhats, Angaja. And he is also sometimes explained to have been the previous incarnation of the first Karmapa Dusun Kempa. In fact, there is a great Gelugpa Lama, Wangdu Lama, in his collected works, when he lists the incarnations of the Karmapas, he says first Potoa and then second Dusun Kempa. So this is a different way of counting it from how we normally count it. So he said that first there was Potoa and then second was Dusun Kempa. So this is a well-known way of counting the Karmapa. Now this text is called the Long Soliloquy. So a soliloquy means that you're speaking to yourself. And when you talk about it, there are a couple of different ways you can understand this. One way that you can understand this is that it means that there's no one to listen. No matter how much you talk, there's no one who will listen. And so when you speak, the only person you can speak to yourself. No matter how many instructions you give, there is no one who will listen to the instructions, no matter how valuable they are. And so for that reason, it is like a rather discouraged or depressing, and there's no one else to speak to but yourself. And so there's a sort of sadness or weariness to this. Yet another way to think about a soliloquy or speaking to yourself is that when you're staying all alone, then all of a sudden you feel inspired and you think to yourself, oh, I need to do this. There's this plan that comes up in your mind and you think, I need to do this, I have to do this. Up to this point, this hasn't worked out. From now on, I need to do better, I need to do this. And so in this way, when you're thinking about it, it's like you're inspired. Generally, when we talk about a soliloquy or speaking to yourself, normally we speak about Dharma and we teach it outside to others, but it's not like that. Sometimes we need to turn it inside. We need to direct ourselves inside and speak to ourselves. We need to advise ourselves. We need to consult with ourselves and advise ourselves. Sometimes always directing our words outside is not so beneficial. And instead, we need to think about them inside. When we think about always teaching others, then often it's like the person who's teaching the Dharma has no real practice themselves. And it's like as Drupad Kune said, whenever you see a throne set up for someone to teach the Dharma, the person on top of it never has any practice. And so these are two different meanings or two different interpretations of the word soliloquy. Have no ambitions for old age. I think that without any thought of living until you are old, you should have no concern at all for whether you will be happy or sad in old age, whether people will respect you, whether you will have enough food and clothing, or whether people will criticize you. You should think, let people do as they will, and have no thought for the ways and means of this life. You should think, whatever will be in this life will be, and leave it to karma. Now we often talk about the empowerments, transmissions, and instructions. There are many different interpretations of what we mean by instructions. But in the instructions by the 8th Karmapa Mikyo Dorje, there's a particular nice explanation, and by nice, it's a rather humorous explanation of the meaning.
Nghe ti na part pa jenga thien ro to man nghe chen ro chu min dus 데네 인두산에 나라 답시 가면도스 아 고란주 시야베 데바레스 에티 티싱면도스 가라에서는 고란주 파티엔 로두스 제자 티자데 고아지 드레시 람나 티니 간다르지 디상게 람스 디디제레다 누구쭈니 람나 떼니 따이지게도 마스 가이드 친드니 반로레다스 라디 데란 로로미스네 베 시사카로 파친지 신비나 아니다 티와게 요마라다 드니 두사 디규젠 떼네 다당아 로종 티 급디 로종 티체리 와르 제자 로종 티챠데 따이모네드네 상게 사 상게 살라 이처럼 만드는 이즈카 드로나 드네 로단 드루 어다 지 가르레 지 드디지레다 주주 윤주산 디 주주 번지 디젤 롤 디엔 롤 마손 디젤 마손 티야메 티야메 요마 제사 디균센 데네 다 디 고아데 아버지도 섬자
Now, the Tibetan word that we translate as instruction actually means guiding, guidance. And so at that point, at that time, when Mikyo Dorje was around, there were some people who said that Mikyo Dorje doesn't... There were some people who said that Mikyo Dorje does not know how to give good instructions. He doesn't know how to give good guidance. He's not like his predecessors. Mikyo Dorje does not know how to give guidance and instructions. And so he wrote in his instructions that some people say that I don't know how to give good instructions, how to give good guidance. And that's quite true. I don't know how to give good guidance. No matter how much I guide people, no one will go where I guide them. When I give instructions, when I give guidance, it's to guide people to the four kayas, to the state of Buddhahood. But no one's going to go. No matter how much I try to pull them along, they just won't budge and they won't come. And so there's no point. If they won't move, then it's not guidance. It's like when you teach or we give instructions, you're pointing the way, you're showing the path. And if no one else will, and if the other people will not go and they end up going somewhere else, then it's not guidance at all. And so it's the same here with these instructions or guidance on mind training. These are instructions that if we follow them will actually take us to the level of Buddhahood if we will go. They are pointing the way. They are showing how it is we're supposed to go and showing the path. And so we must go. If we do not go, then they give no guidance. And so I think this is a very nice interpretation of the word.
ji ngone chene mida ba nyamshe zuor nan de men ro cha da ti gyun zen de ne tu le ka du ne ji gar zhe da long me ba so mar ba da ji da da ji de long yo ma re da du ju yo ma re so mar ji de ji ge be gar zhe tu be tu de ji che zhu ya la tu de cha ba da che zhu ya la be ji gar zhe da ji 당 알아 들으면서 이제 대화 여행이 드리지기 다 가사를 차리 아래 제가 뒤 균세 된 다 드리지 용과 다 가르쳐 버렸으나 다 조디 치와미다 왜 줄죠 치와미다 왜 줄을 총말로 대신에 안다 지금은 이제 나 삼월로 시주 이만 다 쳐서도 아주 미지 날로야 다 최대비 니주시라야 맞다 니주 망고치 지 가르쳐에 타치 가르쳐에 지 니데 용거레 니데 용거 말하지 아주 타 지 땡땡 지 아주 타제 더 깔 하고 싶어 나 이번에 타쳐 되고 지구도 가르쳐잖아 지구도 다 타쳐 살다 그 계획 님은 지구인 뭐 타쳐 살다 다들이야 아주 양결지 아주 타쳐인 지구인다 미나스 지 양가 삼 동고 뭐네 다 치규인바나 다쳐 다 되네 다나신 거두시기 예매디 하고야 거두시기 예매디 하고나다 맞아 야지 데즈지 처시로 쇠체 아 다 니두 내가 되지 아이 니네 데바 내가 되지 아이 니네 데바 내가 신다 차이 데즈지 섭다는 사야 얼마 데 처신의 사야 말았어 가두시기 하고 만났어. 다 와나? 찍디 가라했잖아. 찍 치외기 찍 년가 년가 됐어. 찍 치와 영화가 년가 됐어. 하고나 대 미용야 원고체. 봐 나서든지 미용야를 원고 갚게버는시 원고체나. 근데 바지 시그 말해서 사람 등으로 봐. 이내 따뜻 가라고 싶었어. 네 지금 말해서 아직 찍어요 말해서 강가로 치위 괜찮으러스. 니주 강가로 치위 괜찮으러스. 제가 네 지금 말다 저랑 네 전에 연가요 말은 네 자원이네 지금 말했지 시에도 가라고 싶어. 삼성 서서 맞지는 짬바산이야 신동근 좀 먹고 싶어. 아, 야디 짬바산이지 아주 배유래 맛이 짬바지주. 짬바까먹고랑 감지 디나로를 차다시다 강가 먹는지 짬바까먹고랑 감지 삼성 디 사당 마시네 디 짬바 딘드는 가네 안 가시 딘데 싫어버렸어 그랬어 제가 치위겐 많다치 순비겐 주야 치위겐 차용주사 치위겐 들었다 원고 차자는 많다치 디 치요는 디 겐시는 시 시그는 되게 괜찮지 시그 말해서 매딩에 아 상원로게 지 치위 괜찮고 예비 있다 원고샤 매
The great Potoa himself, I think, his primary practice was the meditation on impermanence. And so he had a great realization of death. He had felt like, it seemed like he was in a great hurry. He felt like it was like he had no time to waste, that he had no time to sit still. It was like he was always worrying about whether he would be able to accomplish Dharma. So he was an individual who was always in a great hurry to practice the Dharma. And I think the reason for this is that the main point is that death and impermanence is definite. It's definite that we will die in this life. There is not much in this life that is certain. There are many situations where we can say maybe this will happen or maybe that will happen, but we cannot definitely say whether or how anything will happen. But there is one thing that is definite, and that is that we are going to die. From the very moment, from the day we have been born, it is certain, it is definite that we are going to die. We may not know how or when, but it is certain that at some point we are going to die. And yet we do not know when we are going to die. And because we do not know when we are going to die, we start making plans. We think to ourselves, oh, I'll do this for this amount of time, and then at that point I'll do this or that. And yet we cannot really make any plans. We do not know whether we'll, when we will die or whether we will get them. And so we will, there's this great danger of death, and it's a great, and we need to understand that there's a great danger of death, and that there's nothing we can do to inoculate ourselves from death to make certain that we are not going to die. It is definite that we're going to die. And so we really cannot say that what is going to cause our death. There are many things that will cause death, and even the things that support our life, even the things that sustain us, can also become the causes of dying. So we cannot say, if you do this, you will die, if you don't do that, you will not die, or if you do that, you will not die. We cannot prevent it. In fact, even eating tsampa, we can even die eating tsampa. Like in my homeland, we mix tsampa and tea, and if you don't know how to mix it well, then it gets stuck in your throat. You can choke on it and die. There are many people who've died this way. And so there are too many causes of death, and even the causes of life, the things that sustain us in this life, can eventually cause our death. And so we do not know what will eventually cause our life. And there is no, we do not know what will eventually cause our death, and there is no way that we can inoculate ourselves so that we will not die.
And
so now please think about this, the meaning of death and impermanence, and meditate on it for 5 minutes.